中模对于半导体产业的重要性。但讨论到台湾品牌的困境呢，夏戴尔博士却认为关键就在于台湾人太过谦虚，甚至在今天之前他根本没有听过宏达电 HTC 这个品牌。
各位观众朋友大家好，我们今天非常荣幸邀请到了欧洲品牌之父夏戴尔博士以及他的合伙人陈玉婷小姐来接受我们的专访。夏戴尔博士不仅是包括可口可乐等500多家企业领袖的老师，而且呢也曾经担任过时代杂志的总编辑。我们来欢迎博士和合伙人。 Hello, nice to meet you.
Pleasure.
And the first question we want to ask is that do you use smartphone?
Yes, I do. I do. Sometimes I don't do, but it depends on the day and the situation.
Which brand do you use?
Today I'm using Samsung.
Samsung. So why do you choose this brand?
Because before I had the iPhone and I had the BlackBerry, and I found it too much, too complex. So I didn't need that sophisticated. So I found a little Samsung, which was very good for me.
We are curious about that. Do you know the Taiwan's brand HTC?
No, because HTC is not so well known in France yet. It will become new, but today not so much new.
So when you travel in Taiwan, this is your first time to know the HTC this brand, right?
Yeah.
What's the problem for that? Because in the global smartphone market, HTC and Samsung and iPhone become the three...major smartphone company in the world. But you don't know HTC, but you know Samsung and iPhone. So what's the problem, do you see?
Well, maybe the problem is that HTC does not communicate as much as Samsung, for example. You know, when you see the amount of advertising, publicity, public relations made by Samsung, you are impressed.Anytime I travel myself, I travel a lot. You know, going to the airport, you coming back to another airport, you find Samsung everywhere. I don't see many advertising from HTC.
If HTC want to make it more popular, what way they have to use?
It's a problem of communication.
Communication.
Yes, I think a lot of people in France know the quality of a smartphone, HTC, but it seems that HTC is not a company who realized how much communication you have to develop, especially today in this highly competitive world.
How to communication, because they also buy ads and to promote their product, but it seems effectiveness.
You know, well, I think first you have to use social media, of course. Don't rely exclusively on social media. Posters in the street, big stores, and very modern and highly sophisticated stores likeApple Store. I live next to an Apple Store. It's amazing to see the number of people from Apple who are available and talking and training, educating, showing what is the best way to use Apple. You know, Apple is investing so much money to promote, to develop those same store. So,if they do it, and I think they do it very, very successfully, there must be a reason. It becomes a lifestyle, and it also, they almost go beyond enough to create a family of people, you know, who are accustomed to go to the store, to meet the same people, to participate, to discussion groups, and so on. And people go, myself, I have an Apple in my home, andI feel as a member of the family. You can create a new lifestyle beyond an Apple lifestyle. Or you have to have very new ideas. You know, if I was HTC, I would not think of creating a specific lifestyle for HTC. But I would focus on making known the background of this company, the history, the values of this thing.How do they behave? Who are the men at the top or women at the top of the company? Mm-hmm. Where do they come from? How were they educated? You know, today everybody knows about the family history of Steve Jobs. Mm-hmm. I must confess, I must say that I don't even know the name of the CEO of HTC.
And in fact, Samsung spent a lot of money in the marketing spends. This year is the first time their marketing spends oversee the research expense. And both in HTC, they spend double money in their marketing expense. So do you think that in the future, the smartphone plays, their marketing competition will be more intense?
I think in the future, HTC or other companies should investigate through market surveys how people to whom they want to talk and with whom they want to interact, how they feel, how they understand the philosophy, the management style of HTC. Because, you know, when you invest so much money to develop a marketing strategy, from time to time you have to control the efficiency, the profitability of this action.
And how about the notebook company in Taiwan, like ASUS and Acer? Do you know them?
No, I don't know. I know Acer.
Yeah, Acer and
Acer. Okay. Acer has a very good reputation, but a reputation of good technology, good quality, but very limited communication compared to Dell. For example, myself, I receive every week in my home, in my mailbox, leaflets, brochure, catalog from there. I never received anything from Acer.
So, up to now.
I don't know. I don't know Acer people. I don't know the company. I don't know what do they have in mind. About their strategy, their communication strategy, I don't know.
How about ASUS, A-S-U-S, ASUS?
I don't see when I, you know, I coming from university, I go often to bookstores. I see a lot of books about Dell computers, about IBM, about Apple. I never saw a book on Acer.
Taiwan's popular brand, but in Europe it seems like nobody knows them. So what's the problem? Do you think that we have to spend more money to communicate with Europe people?
If the problem is more, it's more than money. The problem is, do you believe, are you aware that communication is a domain, is a field as important as manufacturing good quality products? You know, a good manufacturer must be proud of the quality of the products he makes. Now, communication, is it really important? For example, myself, I've been making a living in the field of marketing. In my family, many members of my family say, oh, Dominic, you're in the field of marketing, but marketing is common sense. You know, it's common sense. I mean, you communicate, you speak, okay, you explain, okay. If you were a specialist in law, or in finance, or in logistics, then we would listen to you. I mean, you would be a real professional. Marketing, well, don't spend too much money on marketing. It's common sense. Well, my own feeling is that since I am in Taipei today and meeting Taiwanese, I think Taiwanese are rather modest people. Modest. I mean, humble. They're coming from China or Korea, where people are much more aggressive, much more explicit. Here, you know, you may be number one in the world regarding the quality of the product. You don't feel needing to say it. Now, if you don't say anything about the extraordinary quality of your product, who will say it? Not your competitors, of course. So, you know, first the problem the ethical problem is to be aware that communication, selling, is as important, if not more important, than making, manufacturing. You can be the best in the world in manufacturing. If you don't know how to sell what you manufacture, you don't exist. You don't exist.
Thank you very much.台湾企业发展品牌之路经营起来不太容易，但是就如夏戴尔博士所说，台湾如果能够把谦虚的美德转换成积极的宣传，就能带领我们走向国际。
台湾的品牌行销出了什么问题？提供给大家做参考。休息一下，再回到我们的开讲现场。